Gendry!
Once he gets to the pen, they won't provide the little pig with the bulletproof vest to protect him from some mad brother who he shot in the chest, a place under arrest. Fuck you!
I gotta ask y'all first, because, I mean, both of y'all have done a lot of work before y'all became notorious in certain characters, but now everybody's talking about Netflix and chill, and so many people watch Breaking Bad and Walking Dead on Netflix. What do you guys Netflix and chill with?
Eastbound and Down, Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
Making a Murderer was a good one.
Yeah.
House of Cards. There's such incredible TV.
Wait, does Netflix and chill just mean Netflix shows? I'm not really caught up on the
it
on the Lego.
Be like,
it doesn't
a generic
have to be
thing,
Netflix
like, no.
Originals, but
okay, good.
It might just mean like binge watching nowadays.
Yeah,
those are the things. That
yeah.
So how has it been from that point in your career to now, as far as characters that's been offered to you, after I did these shows that were such cult classics that had such a big fan following? Did you see the type of roles that you were offered and read for start to change?
I mean, it's no secret that if you're successful on a TV show, you get more offers for other things. You earn it, but it helps. You can't say it doesn't help. I haven't really been offered any rednecks since I've been on The Walking Dead, but I have. I remember I did a film early on where I cried just the whole thing, and then I just got a bunch of cry scripts.
Right.
You know what
wow,
I mean?
You
like,
can cry.
Yeah, like one talking baby
no,
movie,
can
ten
cry.
Talking
yeah.
baby movies. You know, but it does open up a bunch of doors for you. You know, which is awesome. You know.
Get off me! I ain't gonna get off you, little brother, because you're gonna end up dead. You haven't seen the same me and Marcus seen,
huh? Why? Navy SEAL again, huh?
Mike is pissed. But Mike's still Mike. These other two, Marcus and Franco? Hey. Do we gotta worry about that?
Cops look after cops. Same as you special ops do. It's fine.
People always, you know, I guess police codes have come up in rap songs with 187 and 211, but I wasn't familiar with 999. Did you guys just have any knowledge of like these police codes that
me?
I know some police codes, but I didn't know what 999 was.
Yeah.
I do now, though.
You do now. It's illustrated greatly with this movie and this cast. And how was it working with Kate Winslet in that role? Like, I haven't seen her do anything like a mob boss before. It seemed like that was one of the most interesting characters stand out as like a turn on a character.
She's a badass, that girl. She's I wasn't in the scenes with her, unfortunately. I wish I was. But I mean, you know, she's Kate Winslet. She commands a room, that girl. So I remember when I first saw her in the cut with her in it, I was just like, whoa, like she didn't even seem like herself. Yeah. She's just such a powerful actress, you know.
When you have a cast like this with so many great actors, with Chiwetel and Anthony Mackie and Woody and you guys, like, do y'all feed off of each other? Does it feel a little bit like being on an all-star team and sort of y'all feeding off of each other?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, the pressure's there. You always want to bring your A-game when you're coming to work, but it's so nice to go to work with people that you really look up to and respect, and you just kind of get an inside look at their process, and it's fantastic.
I always love you guys on screen. Keep on doing it.
Thank you.
On the big screen. Appreciate
it, brother.
Pleasure, bro.
All right, good to see you again, man.